Hi, I'm Chief Meteorologist Tony Petrocca in the Pinpoint 12 Forecast Center. You clicked on the Weather Now link. Pretty busy late this afternoon and early evening. We're taping this now as of about 7:30. We were tracking this line of intense snow showers, snow squalls. They were very localized and brief. But this is a look back between roughly 4 and 6 o'clock this evening. Doesn't look like much, but that narrow strip of green producing some intense, brief bands of snow, putting down a coating of snow, gusty wind, and a poor visibility. This is all ahead of an Arctic cold front. Now, that precipitation is now offshore. It's left some areas with a coating of snow this evening and some slipperiness, but that is long gone. Okay, that's not, let's see. I know Providence has some lights. Probably a bad camera. But what we're looking at is an Arctic cold front, and it's passing through right now. And it's going to bring some of the coldest air of the season. Now, these snow squalls that the front created have pushed offshore, so that risk is done. Now we're going to watch for the big temperature drop, the increase in the wind. Wind chills are going to be a factor. Come Thursday morning, they'll be at or just below zero. But at least we'll be starting a quieter stretch of weather in terms of precipitation. So the snow squalls that we had, and you can see the activity right in here, and they're pushing offshore. Additional squalls upstream in upstate New York and the Great Lakes. A couple of these may sneak in as just a flurry overnight, but we're not anticipating any heavy squalls to come through. They'll be confined to upstate New York. All right, there's the Arctic cold front, leading edge of much, much colder air. So that's pushing offshore, and behind that, you know, you take a look at the temperatures behind the front. Now, this is as of almost 7:30 in the evening. That area of purple represents the core of the bitter cold air. Now, as that air moves in, the wind is going to increase as well, and the net result will be wind chill values below zero by Thursday morning. So we'll take you through the overnight. These are actual air temperatures. It's not the wind chill. 7 a.m. sunshine, 10 to 15 degrees. That's it. And when you factor in the wind, which will be very, very gusty out of the northwest, your wind chill temperatures are going to be running just below zero. So bitter start to the day. In fact, the entire day is cold. Look, even with all day sunshine, the best we can do is about 20, 25 for your Thursday afternoon. The wind chills at times will be in the single digits. And this will continue through the evening and overnight. This is around 11 o'clock. We're back down to around 15 to 20 under mainly clear skies. So the squalls have come to an end. Skies are clear. And again, some areas have a fresh, thin coating of snow on the ground. So there is some slippery roads, at least some of the untreated ones. So be careful of that. And then tomorrow morning, Thursday morning, wow, frigid, sub-zero wind chills. Temperatures starting off in the teens with sunshine, a gusty north-northwest wind, not much better in the afternoon. Actual high temperatures running only about 20, 25 under clear skies and still the gusty wind. All right, seven-day forecast. You know, you look at the wind chill values Thursday morning, you know, below zero at 7 a.m., single digits in the afternoon, and that cold, dry weather extends into Friday. Weekend is dry, and we do see a moderation in temperature, especially by Sunday, 42. Right now, the early call on Christmas Eve Tuesday is sunny, cool, and dry weather for Christmas Day on Wednesday. So wrapping it up, snow squalls are gone, coldest air of the season on the way later tonight, Thursday and Friday. Wind chill is a factor, big time, come Thursday morning. And again, there is some slipperiness out there right now from some of the squalls that came through some areas, not all. All right, that's your latest Weather Now update. Thanks for logging in. We'll talk to you soon.